just think about it for a minute. Call the aunties and uncles, have them cross-examined on their records. The jury will see at once the lad comes from a family of villains who keep a cupboard full of alibis for all occasions.
Yes, of course, you're right.
Of course, the infuriating thing about the alibi is it might even be true.
Mr. Featherstone?
May it please you, my lord. Members of the jury, I appear in this case to prosecute. The defendant is represented by my learned friend, Mr. Horace Rumpole.
Mr. who did you say, Mr. Featherstone?
Mr. Rumpole, my lord. R-U-M-P.
That's right. Spell it out for him, old darling. Mr. Justice Everglade, known to his few friends as Florrie, is a stranger to the Old Bailey. His father was Lord Chancellor round about the time Jim's grandfather was doing over the Streatham Co-op. Educated Winchester and Balliol, cracks the Times crossword in the opening of an egg. Most happy with international trust companies suing each other over nice points of law. Here for a fortnight slumming down the Old Bailey. I wonder what he's going to make of young Peanuts Malloy.
Carrying their takings to a grey Austin van parked in Fawcett Yard, just around the corner. Members of the jury, I think it only fair that you should know that it is alleged that Timpson took part in this attack with a number of other youths, none of whom have been arrested.
The boy stood on the burning deck when saw that he had fled.
It is quite right that you should tell the jury that, Mr. Featherstone. Perfectly right and proper.
If your lordship pleases.
Well, what's this, the old Chums League? Fellow members of the Athenaeum?
I'm most grateful to your lordship for...
Why don't you crawl up on the bench and black his boots for him, old darling?
So I imagine the young man's defence is that he wasn't a justem generis with the other lads.
Well...
I'm sorry, my lord, you were asking about the defence.
Mr. Rumpole.
I am reluctant to intrude on your confidential conversation with my learned friend, my lord, but as Jim Timpson's counsel, I thought that perhaps I might know a little more about his case than the counsel for the prosecution.
I imagine your client says he was not a justem generis with the other lads?
A justem generis, my lord. Oh, yes, he's always saying that. A justem generis is a phrase in constant use in his particular part of Brixton.
Yes. Well done, Dad.
Thanks, Nick. Lovely to see you. Sorry I couldn't turn on a murder for you.
That's all right.
Out at an identity parade. Nevertheless, there is strong evidence against him. Members of the jury, this case isn't based on any alleged confession to the police. Or indeed to anyone in authority. I shall be calling a young man, Malloy, of the same age group as the defendant, to whom you will hear he admitted his guilt in the clearest possible terms.
Not the easiest sort of case, Nick, as you see.
Now, this young man...
Is that your client, Dad?
Yes, that's him. As usual. Oh, my client's invariably in the dock.
Looks as if he ought to be in the fifth form.
Fell into conversation with Timpson during a painting class.
Oh, dear. Oh, Florrie Everglade doesn't know his business. And you're not giving us enough time to get across the road for a decent lunch.
This is fine, honestly.
And one thing you can say against crime, the restaurant facilities aren't up to much.
Didn't you want to have lunch upstairs in the bar mess?
Oh, and you here? Never. I'd rather die than have lunch in the bar mess. It's like the prefect's room in a junior public school. Oh, not your prefect's room, of course.
Talking about school.
A trouble?
Bit of trouble, yes.
Let me tell you at once. There's no need to say a word that might be taken down, used in evidence.
You know the old vicarage opposite the schoolhouse? I mean, it's been empty for years. It's practically falling to pieces.
You helped it fall?
We used to get in there some Sunday evenings. We used it for parties.
Get in there? How exactly?
The kitchen window. didn't leave much opening.
That's a technical break-in under the Forcible Entries Act. What time did you effect this entry?
Pretty late, after chapel.
It's burglary at common law and, of course, civil trespass. What sort of parties, exactly?
We had a poker school.
You haven't run into bankruptcy, have you?
I owe Crabtree £2.10. I mean, we let a lot of people play.
Contrary to the Betting, Gaming and Lotteries Act, 1963.
We used to get a bottle or two of cherry brandy in there.
Serving liquor on unlicensed premises.
Well, Crabtree actually asked a couple of girls from the village, but Bagnall never got to hear about that.
Then there's no evidence of girls. As far as your case is concerned, there is no reason to suppose the girls ever existed. As for the other charges, they are serious.
Yes, I suppose they are, rather.
Well, I suppose you were walking past the place in the evening. You heard the noise, and you went in to investigate.
Dad, Bagnall came in and found us playing poker.
I know. My lord, my client was only playing poker so as not to appear too pious while he lectured his fellow sixth formers against the evils of gambling and cherry brandy.
Dad, be serious.
Serious? Why, don't you want me to defend you?
No. Bagnall's not going to call in the police or anything like that.
Well, what's he going to do?
Well, I'll just miss next term's exeat, do some extra work. I just thought I should tell you before you get a letter.
Yes, thanks, Nick. Thank you, I'm glad you told me. So there's no question of the police?
Police, of course not. No, Bagnall doesn't want any trouble. I mean, after all, still at school.
Still at school? Of course you are. You and young Timpson. Yes. I'm sorry, stupid of me. Yeah, the fish and chips don't look too bad.